Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. Today, I'd like to present you an LED TV from Samsung. It's a 43 inch or 108 centimeters model. It's series 8. This is how the box looks like on the front. We have the series here. We have some technical characteristics here. And we have a picture with the TV itself. On this side of the box, here we have the sticker with the model. So as I was telling you, it's a 43 inch model. So it's UE43TU8072U. So it's series 8. And here we have other characteristics. It's made in Slovakia, so it's in European Union. Let's check the other side of the box. So here on this side, we don't have any information. And on the back of the box, we have just a simple writing here saying it's Crystal UHD. And this is everything we have on the box. This is the back of the box. As you can see here, you also have a sign showing you is the back of the box. I will jump inside the box to see what we can find there. Okay, so this is how the box looks like inside. So here we have the quick setup guide. Okay, what else? Here we have a bag with some accessories. So it's the charging cable, it's the remote control, and the user manual. Okay, we'll have a look at this a little bit later. What else do we have in here? And we have the two legs of the TV. So it's one here and another one here. And this is it. So if we pull this cover out, we'll see the TV, but I need both hands, so I'll take it out and I will show it to you after I manage to take it out from the box. So I took the TV out and this is how it looks. Be careful when you take it out and when you don't have the legs on, make sure to put it on a piece of cloth like this one, not to scratch the screen, okay? So I put it on my little desk, but I make sure to have this piece of cloth here just to keep it safe. And now what we need to do is to insert the legs here in these two sockets. So in the left socket and also on the right socket here. And as you can see, the legs, they look like this. You don't have any screws this time, so you just need to plug this little leg inside. You hear the click and that's it. And in order to make it simple, I don't know if you can see it, but on each leg you have the side of the TV. So in this case, this is R from right, and also on the TV you have R from right, so you cannot really misposition the legs. And of course, make sure when you put the leg to have the leg position in this way, so to be positioned with the in the direction of the exterior of the TV. And here on the leg, as you can see, we have some small rubber parts. That means that the TV will not move around on the desk. So this is how you push it, and then you press, and the same with the left leg, and you press, okay, until you hear a click, and then have a look at the TV. This is how it should look like. And then you can remove the blanket and put the TV on a normal position and start setting it up. Okay, so this is how the TV looks like from the front. As you can see, it comes with a plastic wrap, so you need to take it out. This is very nice. Okay, then it has also plastic wraps on the corners and on the sides. It also has a plastic wrap here on the side. So if you have a brand new TV, you should have all these plastic wraps on the TV. The bezel is very, very slim, but I can tell you, I will tell you a bit more when I will turn on the TV, but it looks very slim. The TV looks very nice. The little legs are matte plastic, so it's not glossy plastic. The bezel here is not glossy. I would say it's a little bit glossy to matte, but it looks very nice. And in terms of thickness, the TV is not very thick, but also is not the slimmest TV I saw. I think it will look good on a wall. It definitely looks good on a desk. So this is how it looks. I will turn it around just to look on the back of the TV. On the back of the TV, we have a plastic with some sort of model, as you can see here. It's matte plastic, but still you can leave your fingerprints all over it. But come on, this is the back of the TV and you really don't care. In terms of connectors, so we have the LAN connector, we have the component connectors, the audio and video connectors, we have the digital audio optical connector, we have an HDMI port here, okay, and here we have another connector, which is the CI slot for the CI card. And here on this side, we have the cable connector, we have the satellite connector, we have one HDMI, we have the second HDMI, and we have two USB ports. One USB port is 5 volts and 0.5 amps, and the second one is 5 volts and 1 amp, so you can have an external 2.5 inch hard disk for movies, for pictures, for whatever you want, and you can connect it here. And what else? And here we have the power slot. This is where we put the power cable. Okay, and this is it. This is all we have on the back of the TV, and as I told you, it's a fingerprint magnet. In terms of accessories, this is what we have inside the box. So we have the magic remote, which personally I have to tell you I don't like. I like the remote with the big and a lot of buttons, but this is what it is. We have the CI adapter, the CI card adapter. We have the power cable, which as you can see comes without the external transformer, meaning that the transformer it's in fact inside the TV, which is very good. And we have two cable organizers, and here we have the user manual, the warranty card, and an user manual for the new remote control. I have to read this because it's the first time when I'm using this kind of remote. And we have some other papers. So this is what you get inside the bag. Okay guys, so I managed to set up the TV and this is how it looks like. But first, let's have a look at the remote control. And as I told you, this is my first time when I'm using such a remote control. I'm used to the classic ones. So the remote control has only a few buttons. It's very basic. So basically here we have the power on, power off button. Here we have a microphone. Here we have the microphone button, which will allow you to control some applications like YouTube, like Netflix, and so on, if you press this button. Here we have the button which will display on the screen the numbers, but also the so-called color numbers or the teletext colors. This is a button which if you press it, the TV will go into a, if you want, screen show mode. So basically you can play your pictures, your movies on the screen. This is the area where you have the navigation button, so up, down, left, right, and OK. And you can use it in different applications to navigate through the menu and so on. This is the back button. This is the home button, where you go to the if you want to the menu of the TV, where you can select the source, or you can select Netflix, YouTube, you can select settings and so on. When you are in a program like Netflix or YouTube, you can use this button to pause or to play a movie. This is a button for volume, and it works like this, up, down, and if you press on it, it will mute your TV. This is the button for the channels, up and down. Okay, and also if you press this button while on the TV, you will see in this case the list of the channels, and you can select via the joystick whatever program you want. Okay, this is okay. And here we have some three dedicated buttons for Netflix, for Amazon Prime, and for Rakuten TV. I think they paid a lot of money to Samsung to include these buttons on the remote control. But apart from this, it's a very basic remote control. It's not so difficult to use, but in my view, I still prefer the old remote control. And here on the back, this is how it looks like. Very basic. This is a cover, and if you take this cover out, you'll see it comes with two AA batteries. Let's put it back. Okay, now let's play a little bit with the TV. So, as you can see, the bezel of the TV is very, very slim. So, in fact, here we have a very slim, like half a centimeter bezel. But if I look at the TV, it looks like a very, very nice one with a slim bezel. So I really like it. For my taste, it's perfect like this. In terms of colors, this is an HD program. The colors are very nice, very vibrant. And of course, you can select which kind of color if you want. You can switch from vivid to naturals and so on. But right from the factory with the default settings, this is how you get it. And as you can see, the colors are very nice. This is the cable TV. Again, it's an HD channel. Unfortunately, I don't have any 4K channel to test it. But on HD, my opinion is that it looks fantastic. So let's play around with the menu. If you want to access the menu and to play with the settings, you have two options. One is to play with the remote control, but if you don't have the remote control with you, you can play with the button that you have here on the TV. If you press the button, you have this quick menu. Okay, and if you hold the button like this, it will execute the command here. If you just press it very short, it will go to the next command. So again, press it and it will execute the command on the screen. So this is how you play with the menu on the TV. Now, if you want to play with the settings, what you have to do, you have to press the home button on the remote control, and then with these buttons you have to navigate, okay, all the way to the settings. And here on the settings you have to navigate with this round button. You have a menu with quick settings, and these are the quick settings that you can access, the picture mode, and you can switch between natural, movie, filmmaker, dynamic, and standard. I like the standard, but again, this is a matter of tastes. You can go to sound mode, and you can switch between adaptive sound, amplify, and standard. I'll leave it to adaptive sound, meaning that it will automatically adapt depending on the type of channel you watch. TV speaker and output, sound output. Again, this is TV speaker. If you want to select optical, you can select optical from this menu. Then subtitles, you can change the subtitles from this menu here. Language for audio. Network, if you want to play with network settings. In my case, it's already connected to the Wi-Fi. The picture size. And you have some sizes here for 3, 16, 9. And custom, I will let it to 16.9. The color tone, again, warm, cool, and standard. Picture clarity. You can play with some settings here. Contrast enhancer, so high, off, low, again high. Some settings about the output, audio output format. Again, here some settings about the picture. I have to admit that I don't know what all these settings are doing, so I'm just showing you the menu. So these are all the options on the quick settings menu. But if you want to go to the full settings menu, you go here on the settings, and now you have the full menu on the screen. And here is the classic standard Samsung menu. You have the picture menu, where you can change between the picture mode, between natural, movie, and so on. So I leave it to standard, the picture size, and you have advanced settings. And as you can see, you can play with brightness, contrast, sharpness, and so on. So basically all the settings that you have in a normal Samsung TV. I will not go through all of this because it will take ages, but just to show you how many settings you can do here from this menu. Then if we go back, we have the sound menu. Here you can select the sound output, TV speaker, optical, or Bluetooth, because yes, you can connect it to a Bluetooth speaker or headphones. The sound mode, okay. And you also have expert settings. And again, here you have a big menu and you can play with all the settings. I don't know what they are doing, so I'm not going to spend time now here. On the broadcasting, here is where you set up the cable TV. So basically you can select auto tuning settings to tune all the channels automatically. And you have here other settings, including advanced settings. You have manual tuning. You can transfer your channel list to an USB stick, and then via an external program you can sort the channel list if you want. And we have other settings here. If we go to general, here we have settings about the voice setup assistant. I'm not going to do it now because it requires a Samsung account and I don't have one on the TV. Network here, if you want to connect the TV to the internet, you can use this menu here. System manager, here you can set up the language, the device name, the pin of the TV, and so on. Time. External device manager, this is another menu which I don't know what it is doing, so I'm not going to spend time. And as you can see, you have plenty of choices to play with. And of course the reset, if you want to reset all the settings to the factory settings, you just use the reset button. Here you have a support area where you can check for software updates, device care, e-manual, and so on. And you have some terms and privacy area. So this is the menu. And if you want to go back, you just press the home menu. And now you are back on the TV screen. Now, if you want to navigate through the channels, you just use this button here. Press up and it goes to another channel. Up and it goes to another channel. If you want to go back, you just slide down this button and it goes down. If you want to play with the volume, again, you just press this button up here. And if you want to lower it, you just press it down. And if you want to mute, you just press it like this. So the remote control is not very complicated. It works very well. Now, I want to test what is the lag between changing the channel. So as you can see, we have a channel here. This is the remote control. So you can see when I press the button. So I press the button now. Again, I press the button now. I press the button now. I press the button now. So as you can see, the channels are changed very fast. I'm pleased with the speed. I also have an LG TV, and I have to say that the LG TV is not as fast as this Samsung. So it's a good job with the channel speed here. I like it. In terms of sound performance, let me do a quick speaker test. I will push it to the maximum and see how it is.
Mai ales în prima repriză, cred că am fost fantastici și în partea a doua am fi putut face mai multe, dar am avut 3-0, la pauză un avantaj sigur. Dar ne bucurăm pentru cele 3 puncte, prima repriză foarte bună, gol, foarte frumos.
Ok, so the sound is very loud, very clear. I like it. Again, I'm using the adaptive sound, so it will automatically adapt depending on the type of channel you are using, but it doesn't have bass. So if you want bass, you have to connect an external speaker or a subwoofer, but it's very loud. I like it, to be honest with you. It's very good. So again, the colors are very nice, very vibrant. I like them. You can play with the color tone. You have a lot of settings. From what I can see here on these channels, I don't see a lot of clouding effect. So I don't see this part of the screen to be on the gray side, which is good, meaning that the panel is of a good quality. Yeah, I cannot see it, at least not on these channels. No. So the image is the same all over the screen. It's good. If we want to go to the smart part of this TV. So again, we press the home button here. And with the navigation buttons, we go to the apps. And here on the apps, we have some predefined apps like Netflix, YouTube, internet, Prime Video, Rakuten TV, Voyo, and so on. But of course, you can go to the App Store if you want. And here on the App Store, you have plenty of apps that you can install on your TV. But you need a Samsung account. So again, you can choose between music and radio applications. And you have a full list of applications that you can install here. Again, let's choose one to show you that I need a Samsung account and I don't have one right now. If I press install, you see it asked me for a Samsung account. But if you have one, you just enter it here and you can install whatever application you want. So again, you have news and weather, smart life, sports, games, video. Let's have a look at games. So here on the games, as you can see, you have a lot of games. Of course, they are basic games that you can play with the remote control, but to kill your time, I think they are perfect. Of course, if you want to kill your time, have a look at our YouTube channel. Okay, let's go back. So you can install a lot of applications, but you know, for the moment, I'm going to have a look at Netflix and YouTube because these are the two applications that I'm using the most. So applications, YouTube. Let's go to YouTube. Open. is not the fastest application I saw on a smart TV, but still it opens quite fast. Let's search for something on our channel. And let's have a look at this latest video. Okay, we have a commercial, of course, because we live out of commercials. And now the video started. And the quality is impressive. It's very nice. The colors are very, very bright, very vivid. I like it. Let's test the sound. Again, the sound is very loud. It does have mids and heights, but it doesn't have bass. So again, if you are looking for a TV with a big bass, this is not the TV for you. But apart from this, it's very clear and very loud. So this is YouTube. Let me choose another movie to see how fast it opens it. This one, for example. Oh, it's quite fast. I mean, it moves very well. And I can see that it automatically goes to HD quality. Yeah. No, very nice. Very good. Let's choose another one, this one. So, once you open the application, it moves very well. I like it. Let's choose Netflix. And this time, I will open Netflix by pressing the button on the remote control. So I'm pressing it now. I go here, and as you can see, I have all the movies that my daughter and myself watched, and of course we can browse. Let's choose a movie which my daughter watches, for example Barbie Dreamhouse, and as you can see, it moves very, very good, very fast. The speed of Netflix is very good. Let's choose another one. So back. You navigate with this button. So let's choose one which I didn't look before. Let's choose this one. So you can see it's instant. It's very fast. Let's keep the intro. Yeah. Very good, very fast. I like it. So it's working very well on the Netflix, but also on YouTube. Let's try to navigate the internet. So go back home. Let's go to the applications. Again, let's go back home. Let's go to application and let's select internet. Internet is loading. It's loading for the first time. Okay, and to navigate, of course, you just move around with these buttons. So let's see how fast it is to open YouTube. Of course, you need to agree with the data. Okay, and as you can see, it takes a bit of time to load the page. But it's loading slowly. It's loading. Okay, but what about opening a certain web page? So let's see, for example, GSM Arena. So again, this is the first time when I'm opening the browser, so we really see how it moves. This remote control is not the best one in terms of navigation. I'm not going to use it for browsing, this is for sure. Okay. And it goes to mobile site. Agree. Yeah, and as you can see, it moves, but it's very slow. So let's open one article, for example, this one here. It moves, but again, it's very slow. No, I don't like it. So it has internet. You can use it if you need it and if you want, but it's very slow, so I don't really recommend it. So let's see what else we have. So we have the live TV. As I told you, it looks very nice, very clear. I like it. If we go again to home, we have this ambient mode where you can project your photos. So if you open the ambient mode, it takes a while to start. And here you can set up the TV to display a range of photos, your photos. So it's like if you want digital photo book. You just put your photos and it will run every photo each and every few seconds. But I'm not going to set it up now because I'm not going to use this TV as a digital frame. So let's see what else we have. So we have the application. I showed you the application. Let's go to gallery. What is this gallery? Okay, so basically if you have a Samsung account and if you have your photos in the Samsung account, in the Samsung cloud, you sign in here and you'll be able to access your photos via the TV. But as I told you, I don't have a Samsung account on this TV, not even on real life, so I'm not going to set it up now. And here you also have the source where you can select between the TV. Let me go again. Remote access. And you have other options here like universal remote. So you can set up the remote in order to be able to control other devices with it, as you can see here. But I don't have other devices from Samsung, so at this moment in time I'm not going to set it up. And remote access, what is this? Let's see. Okay, so basically here you can set up your phone if you want to access the TV with the phone, and if you want to project something from the phone, you can do this by following this menu, by using the Wi-Fi network. It's very nice. You can do it if you want on your own. So let's go back to the TV. So guys, this is it. I'm going to use this TV mainly on the TV mode, but also from time to time on YouTube and Netflix. I believe that this is a very nice TV. I like the colors, I like the way it looks, and again the menu and the operating system moves quite well. Let me open Netflix once again to see how it goes. So I'm pressing it now. And as you can see, it's instant. So pretty good. I'm happy with it. I'm going to test it for a few weeks and I'm going to let you know if I have any problems with this TV. But for the moment, It is very nice. And I have to tell you that I paid around 300 euro for it. And in this range of price, I think this was the best choice. Of course, there are other models from competition like LG and Sony, but I'm a Samsung fan. I have a lot of Samsung devices, so this is why I choose this TV. Okay, if you like this video, please feel free to subscribe to our channel and also hit the like button. Thanks for watching.